In this video, we'll take an overview of Live's user interface. We'll focus on getting accustomed with how to navigate the interface and where to find different parts of the software. We won't cover each section in detail, as these will be covered in depth in separate videos. By the end of this video, you should have a good idea of how to navigate within Live and find different sections of the software. Live's user interface is designed to be modular. Different sections can be hidden and shown as needed using several toggles around the interface. One useful area to be aware of when getting started with Live is called the Info View. This can be hidden and shown using the toggle in the bottom left. The Info View provides information about any part of Live's interface simply by hovering your mouse over that element. As I move my mouse around Live's interface, you'll see that the Info View updates with information about that section, down to the level of individual buttons and controls, and even mentions keyboard shortcuts when available. If you're new to Live, leaving the Info View open is recommended to learn about any interface elements at a glance. At the top of Live's interface is the control bar, which always remains visible no matter where you are in Live. This contains things like your project tempo and time signature, Live's metronome, and the key and scale of currently selected clips. In the middle of the control bar, you'll find the arrangement position indicator, play, stop, and record buttons, and several buttons related to recording, like MIDI overdub, automation arm, capture, and session record. To the right of this are arrangement loop controls, loop start and loop length controls, controls for punch in and punch out, and the loop switch. On the right-hand side of the control bar are controls for draw mode, computer MIDI keyboard, and key and MIDI mapping. You can also see your project sample rates and current CPU usage. On the left-hand side of the interface is the browser. This is where you'll find and load all the instruments, sounds, and effects you'll use in your project. The browser can be toggled using the button in the top left. There is an additional toggle to the right of the browser button to show and hide Live's tuning and groove pool sections. At this point, it's worth mentioning that different interface elements are resizable by clicking and dragging. There are also several shortcuts for toggling interface elements. These will differ slightly on Mac and PC, but you can always find them by going to the View menu. For example, Option Command 5 toggles the browser on Mac. The main section of the interface is where you'll spend most of your time making music. Live has two main views that can be toggled using the icons in the top right. Currently, we're looking at Live's Arrangement view, where you arrange the parts of your song on a timeline. Tracks that contain the instruments and sounds in your project run horizontally, and the track header is found on the right-hand side. Let's click the icon to switch to the session view. In the session view, our tracks are shown vertically as columns. The top section of tracks in the session view shows our clips, the pieces of MIDI and audio in our project. At the bottom is the mixer section. Here we see things like track volume, panning, solo, mute, and record arm buttons, and send controls if available. The mixer can be toggled using the icon at the bottom right. The toggle to the right of the mixer icon lets us hide and show different parts of the mixer as needed. At the right-hand side of the session view are our return tracks and the main track. Return tracks are commonly used for setting up effect sends. The main track is where all our tracks are summed together before being sent to our speakers. If we switch back to the arrangement view, you'll see that the mixer section can also be shown here, including returns and the main track. The arrangement mixer can be resized by clicking and dragging at the top of the mixer. At the very bottom of the interface is the detail view. This can be toggled using the two tabs in the bottom right. You can either show the device view, where you see all the instruments and effects for the currently selected track, or the clip view, where you'll see the contents of the currently selected clip. The clip view can be resized by clicking and dragging at the top of the view. You can also see the device view and clip views simultaneously by clicking the toggles next to each tab. This will stack with the mixer view if you have enough screen space. Lastly, let's see how to navigate within the arrangement view. Above and below the arrangement view are the beat and time rulers. If you hover your mouse over the beat ruler, it will change to a magnifying glass. You can then click and drag up and down or left and right to zoom and pan the arrangement. You can also use the plus and minus keyboard shortcuts to zoom in and out of your arrangement. At the top of the arrangement is the overview, which shows an overview of all the clips in your arrangement. Click and drag at the bottom of the arrangement overview to expand its size. You can also click and drag up and down and left and right within the arrangement overview to zoom and pan the display. Within the arrangement, click on the toggles next to a track's name to fold and unfold that track. Hold Alt or Option and click any of these toggles to fold and unfold all tracks simultaneously.